We want to solve the given equations. Analyzing the two equations, notice how they somewhat resemble quadratic equations, even though they're not quadratic equations. Looking at the quadratic form of an equation, in terms of u, we would have au squared plus bu plus c equals 0. Let's see if we can verify the first equation is in quadratic form. Notice if it is in quadratic form, u would be equal to square root m, and u squared would be equal to m. Let's verify that actually is true. Let's let u equal the square root of m, which indicates that u squared would be equal to the square of the square root of m, which is equal to m. This verifies the given equation is in quadratic form. If we wanted to, we could replace m with the square of the square root of m. To make it more resemble a quadratic equation. Or we could also go as far as replace the square root of m with u and write the equation as u squared minus 9u plus 20 equals 0. Let's go ahead and factor this with the equation written in terms of u. If it does factor, it'll factor into two binomial factors, where in the first positions we have u and u because the first term is u squared. The second terms are the factors of positive 20 that add to negative 9, which are negative 5 and a negative 4, giving us a factor of u minus 5 and a factor of u minus 4. Now again, because we are solving for m, not u, let's go ahead and perform a substitution and replace u with the square root of m. This gives us a factor of the square root of m minus 5 and a factor of the square root of m minus 4. If this product must equal 0, then the square root of m minus 5 must equal 0, or the square root of m minus 4 must equal 0. And now we solve these square root equations for m. For the first equation, we add 5 to both sides, giving us the square root of m equals 5. To solve for m and undo the square root, we square both sides, giving us m equals 25. Or, for the second equation, we add 4 to both sides, giving us the square root of m equals 4. Square both sides to solve for m, and we have m equals 16. First equation has two solutions, but because it does have a square root, we should verify both solutions actually work. And I've already set this up on the calculator. We substitute 25 for m in the original equation, and then substitute 16 for m in the original equation and make sure the left side equals 0. And notice both solutions do satisfy the equation. And now let's take a look at our second equation. Notice it resembles the same form, where if we did want to perform substitution, we would have u equals the square root of p, and therefore u squared equals the square of the square root of p, which does equal p. Let's go ahead and write the equation as the square root of p squared minus 3 square root p minus 18 equals 0. At this point, we may be able to recognize it's in quadratic form and skip replacing the square root of p with u and go straight to the factored form. If this does factor, it'll factor into two binomial factors, where because the first term is a square of the square root of p, we have the square root of p in the first positions. For the second positions, we want the factors of negative 18 that add to negative 3, which are negative 6 and positive 3, giving us a factor of the square root of p minus 6 and the square root of p plus 3. Notice negative 6 times 3 is negative 18, and negative 6 plus 3 is negative 3. Because the product on the left must equal 0, we have the square root of p minus 6 must equal 0, or the square root of p plus 3 must equal 0. And now we solve both equations for p. For the first equation, we add 6 to both sides, which gives us the square root of p equals 6. And then we square both sides to undo the square root and solve for p, giving us p equals 36. Or, for the second equation, we subtract 3 on both sides, which gives us the square root of p equals negative 3. We need to be careful here. This is the principal square root of p, meaning the positive square root of p, This is never going to equal negative 3, and therefore this second factor does not give us a second solution. However, if we don't catch this, we may continue and square both sides, and we'll get a second value for p, but it won't satisfy the original equation. So I'm going to go ahead and continue on, even though I know right now this is not going to give us a solution. Let's just say I did want to square both sides. I'll do this in a different color. And notice here we get p equals the square of negative 3 is positive 9. But again, this is not going to satisfy the equation, which we'll now verify. So notice p equals 36 does satisfy the equation, but p equals 9 does not satisfy the equation. P equals 9 is what we call an extraneous solution. It's when we make it algebraically, but it doesn't satisfy the equation. But as long as we pay attention when we have the square root equation, we should be able to catch this. But this does show why it's so important to verify a solution actually satisfies a given equation. I hope you found this helpful.